He no doubt feared that by this opening she might still by some diabolical means corrupt her guards. Milady smiled with joy. She was free now to give way to her transports without being observed. She traversed her chamber with the excitement of a furious maniac or of a tigress shut up in an iron cage. Certes, if the knife had been left in her power, she would now have thought, not of killing herself, but of killing the Baron. At 6 o'clock Lord de Winter came in. He was armed at all points. This man, in whom Milady till that time had only seen a very simple gentleman, had become an admirable jailer. He appeared to foresee all, to divine all, to anticipate all. A single look at Milady apprised him of all that was passing in her mind. "Ah," said he, "I see, but you shall not kill me today. You have no longer a weapon, and besides, I am on my guard. You have begun to pervert my poor Felton. He was yielding to your infernal influence. But I will save him. He will never see you again. All is over. Get your clothes together. Tomorrow you will go. I had fixed the embarkation for the 24th, but I have reflected that the more promptly the affair takes place, the more sure it will be. Tomorrow, by 12 o'clock, I shall have the order for your exile, signed Buckingham. If you speak a single word to anyone before going aboard ship, my sergeant will blow your brains out. He has orders to do so. If, when on the ship, you speak a single word to anyone before the captain permits you, the captain will have you thrown into the sea. That is agreed upon. Au revoir, then. That is all I have to say today. Tomorrow I will see you again to take my leave." With these words the Baron went out. Milady had listened to all this menacing tirade with a smile of disdain on her lips, but rage in her heart.